Hi guys, welcome to another lesson on Niti Aayog's year-end review of 2018. Today we are going to take last four questions or MCQs on the year-end review of 2018, and that is going to help us understand a lot of things about what happened in the year 2018. Well, if you're preparing for the upcoming NABARD and RBI examination, do watch the complete video in order to not only understand information or get information about these examinations, about things that can be asked, but also at the same time to understand how to learn better, faster and in a smarter manner. So let's start with the video. As you can see here, the question says, which of the following is the correct objective of Model Agricultural Produce and Livestock Marketing Committee APLMC Act, which has been recently passed. Now it's very important, and let me connect it with something that I discussed very recently. If you have not seen it, go and watch it, because I am forecasting a lot of questions from that particular report. India at 75, the report released by Niti Aayog. I discussed farmers' welfare in a total of three parts, and that is the most important area, especially for NABARD, because as you know, NABARD focuses on farming. So questions from areas like these, which have already been implemented or which have been envisioned by Niti Aayog and recommended by Niti Aayog, those kind of things can be picked up by NABARD and asked in the examination. For sure, some questions are going to come from those areas. So do watch those three videos, which cover all those three parts of farmers' welfare envisioned in the report of India at 75. Well, this I had discussed in detail at that point of time, so I'm not going to discuss it again here. But I wanted to reinforce that this is an important area from which question can be asked. The question is, which of the following is the correct objective of Model Agricultural Produce and Livestock Marketing Committee Act? The options are to help farmers directly connect with the different buyers and enable them to discover optimum price for their commodities. To help farmers indulge in mixed farming, as it says, Livestock Marketing Committee, to activities in order to supplement their income, to encourage local production and local distribution of food products, to help farmers double their income by farming staple crops like rice and wheat, which are a part of minimum support price. What do you think is the correct answer of this question? A very logical question. If you have understood the problems with APMC Act and what are the solutions which are being envisioned under APLMC, then you would be able to answer this question very easily. Provide your answers in the comment section below before I tell you the answer to this particular question. Well, the answer to this question is A, to help farmers directly connect with different buyers and enable them to discover the optimum price for their commodities. Not a lot of discussion on this particular question, because I've already discussed it in the APLMC Act discussion that I told you under India at 75. Do watch that particular lesson also. What do you mean by price deficiency payment system recommended by Niti Aayog? A very, very important question. A total of three recommendations have been made, and let's talk about all of them one by one. Very important. Three questions or one question out of these three is certain to be asked either in phase one or in phase two. I can bet on that. The question is, what do you mean by price deficiency payment system? First option, MSP to be replaced with deficiency between farmer's cost price and selling price of various crops to be paid to the farmer by the government. MSP to be replaced with deficiency between farmer's MSP and market price of various crops to be paid to the farmer by the government. MSP to be replaced with deficiency between farmers' MSP and selling price. So these are the only changes that you can see here. MSP to be replaced with deficiency between farmers' cost price and selling price. So of course, if you have not gone through it, very difficult to answer this question. The correct answer is MSP. The correct answer here is MSP and market price. The way you can remember it is MSP. Or you can just write MSP and circle S. That means MSP to MP. That is the conversion. That is how you can remember it. So the answer, as I said, B, MSP to be replaced with deficiency between farmers' MSP and market price. Now let's Okay, I believe, yes, there is another question on this particular area, and then we will talk about all these three recommendations that have been provided by Niti Aayog. Okay, so let's pick up the next question. Which of the following is not one of the alternative mechanisms to implementation of MSP proposed by Niti Aayog? So what happened is, this is Niti Aayog. It made recommendations under alternate mechanisms to implement MSP, and there are three recommendations under this. The question is, which of these following is not one of these alternative mechanisms? The first one is price support scheme, PSS. Second is price deficiency payment scheme, PDPS. We've already understood this through the last question. Third is private procurement and stockist scheme, PPPS. And the fourth is procurement of paddy, wheat and nutrient, nutri cereal scheme, PPWNS. Very difficult question indeed if you have not gone through any of these recommendations. The answer to this question is D. D has just been made up by me. It's not one of these recommendations of alternative mechanisms. The options are three. A, price support scheme. Remember this, PSS. B, price deficiency payment scheme. Deficiency among what? MSP. S is circled. That means deficiency between MSP and market price. Private procurement and stockist scheme, PPPS. Let's try and understand one of the two of them, which we have not read one by one. What is the meaning and what happens under price support scheme? Physical procurement of pulses, oil skids and copra will be done by central nodal agencies with proactive role of state governments. It is also decided that in addition to NAFED, Food Cooperation of India will take up price support scheme operations in states or districts. The procurement expenditure and losses due to procurement will be borne by the central government as per the norms. There is no shortcut to this. You have to mug up this. Number one, physical procurement of pulses, oil seeds and copra. Number one, to be done by central nodal agencies, FCI, NAFED, with proactive role of state governments. In addition to NAFED, FCI will take up PSS in states and districts. So before this, NAFED used to look after price support scheme in states and districts, but FCI used to look after them at the central level. But now both of them are going to work at both central and state level. Okay, losses to be borne by central government as per norms. PDPS, we've already understood. No need to discuss this. The third one here is PPPS, participation on private sector in procurement operations. So procurement till now has been done by FCI and NAFED. Now they are saying private sector should also become be a part of procurement operations. And a pilot project on this has already gone underway. Needs to be piloted so that on the basis of learnings, the ambit of private participation in procurement operations may be increased. Therefore, in addition to PDPS, it has been decided for oil seeds, states have the option to roll out PPPS or PPSS, as you can say it. So this is another potential area where a question can be asked. What is the area where PPPS or PPSS, as you can call it, has already been decided by the government? It is oil seeds. Okay. Let's come to the last question, which is factual in nature. According to Niti Aayog's report, India Energy Storage Mission, a Make in India opportunity for globally competitive battery manufacturing, by when should India achieve 100% electric vehicles fleet? So this particular report has been released by Niti Aayog, and it aspires that by a certain year, India should have 100% electric vehicles fleet. The answer to this question is B, by the year 2030. Well, that's all for today's lesson. With this, we have covered the entire Niti Aayog India year-end review 2018. I shall be moving forward, and we'll be taking a lot more questions related to ESI. In another series, day-wise series, I'm also covering, my team is also covering the ARD section, and I'm sure you're liking that. If you have any feedbacks, do provide me with these feedbacks by typing in the comment section below. And if you like this lesson, do not forget to subscribe and press the bell icon. And do not also forget to share this video with as many friends and also on your social media platforms so that more and more people can take advantage of these lessons and can learn faster and better for the upcoming examinations. All the very best. Take care.